Hello, Microsoft Security Community. It's Fernanda Vela, and I'm a Project Manager in the Customer Experience and Engineering team for Azure Security Center. And I'm super excited to be here to share a quick look of how the security control enable audit and login looks like. So let's get started.
I'm in the Azure Security Center under recommendations. I'm going to go to open the control enable auditing and login to see which resources are unhealthy. Okay, so I have a few here that luckily have a quick fix button. Let's go ahead and check the auditing on SQL Server should be enabled. I can see this recommendation has some nice features like exempt, enforce, and view policy definition. I can also see the severity of this recommendation, how often this gets refreshed, a description, remediation steps, and my unhealthy resources. So, in a nutshell, the exempt feature helps me create a rule that says, hey, I have already a third-party software that is taking care of this recommendation for this specific resource, or hey, I accept the risk of not solving this recommendation. Now, the enforce feature helps me creating a policy deploy if not exists, which in this specific scenario would be, hey, each time you see an SQL that doesn't have auditing enable, change its configuration to enable. So I will click on this feature. A policy assignment will come up so that I can fill certain fields. In this example, I need to define this scope. I can choose a management group and even do a much more granular selection that goes to a specific subscription and gives the opportunity to choose a resource group. But for now, I will only choose my management group. Know that you can also do exclusion so that this policy doesn't affect a certain subscription or resource group. I'm going to click Next to go to the parameters section. I can modify the retention days or leave it as default. I also need to specify where is the storage account going to live. Then, I will click Next. There is a non-compliance message that you can customize, like check with your security admin. So now, let's click Next, and then Create. As you can see, I got a successful policy assignment creation. Now, this might take up to 30 minutes or so to take effect. Now, let's take a look at another one. Diagnostic logs in Event Hub should be enabled. Here, I have the same scenario that includes the exempt and enforce features. So let's try the exempt one. I need to select the exemption scope that can be a management group, subscription, or resource. I can also select an expiration date and the exemption category. Once I have double-checked everything, I'm going to click Create. This also might take approximately 30 minutes to take effect, so if I return later to this recommendation, the resource I exempted will be in the not applicable resources category with all its details. Now, let's remediate the diagnostic logs in Logic Apps should be enabled. Because this recommendation comes with a quick fix button, I'm able to see the remediation logic before I apply it, just to make sure of the impact it may have. In this JSON file, I can see the metrics and the logs that will be modified to enabled. I'm going to click on the resource checkbox, choose a workspace where this will be stored, and then click the button Remediate Resource. This will also take a few minutes to be reflected in this recommendation, and the resource we selected will then appear in the Healthy Resources. Also, there will be times where a quick fix button is not going to be available. For example, in the Diagnostic Logs in Virtual Machine Scale Set should be enabled. In this type of a scenario, we can take a look at the remediation steps, follow its references, and apply the changes manually. Nevertheless, we have a GitHub repo where we have so many logic apps that can help you remediate faster and even automate the entire process. So I truly suggest that you take a look and join our ASC GitHub community.
So there you have it. Give it a go and let us know how you get on in the comments below this video or in our tech community blog. Of course, don't forget to subscribe to the Microsoft Security Community channel for more videos and updates. See ya.